Hello guys, so welcome to KO Tutorials. So let's continue the next part of this tutorial. So let's get started. So as you can see over here, we have started with the modeling of this particular bedroom design over here in 3ds Max. So let's continue that. So there are a few things left which are left to be done for the modeling part over here. So let's do that. So very first of all, we'll be just creating this selling lights over here. So let's just take a cylinder. You can go to the top view over here and let's create this lights over here. So slightly you can push this up, reduce the height segments over here, convert to editable poly, use this inset and use a bit of bevel over here and click OK. So after that, make multiple copies. So like this, put one over here, one over here, so select this, okay. After that, so we can create this particular flower pot over here. So let's take a cone over here first. So we can just take a cone over here, increase a bit of its height, reduce the radius, so convert to editable poly, select the polygons, use a bit of inset and give a bit of bevel over here. So after this, I can take a line tool over here. I'll off this. So select this part, slightly will increase its height. So select this line, go into this rendering, enable in viewport, so we can just slightly shuffle this over here, push this over here, let's mirror it, copy it in y-axis, we can slightly rotate that. So whatever changes you want, you can do that. You can go into this line over here in the same way. So as how we have done in the previous tutorial, how to create this leaves. So leaves can be easily created over here. You can just take a circle over here and I'll just slightly scale that part and I'll give a extrude modifier over here. After that, I can also give a bend modifier, so I can just slightly give a bend modifier over here. And after that, we can go into hierarchy, effect pivot only. We can slightly shuffle this at the center and we can just make such copies over here in this way. So just select this and scale that. So you can just push it in the correct way. So we can slightly just duplicate that over here. So in whatever ways you want, you can do that. So just you can just group this and shuffle that towards center. So Alt A. So first duplicate that. Alt A and just click OK and drag this over here. So definitely you can make more branches also. So if you want, you can create few of the branches, not a problem. So for now, what I'll be doing is I'll scale it and I'll just push it in the correct way. Okay. So how we can start up with the texturing part over here. So very first of all, you can go into rendering, render setup, and you can set up this V-Ray over here. We'll set up to HD over here. Set up to force to sided. So we'll be using a slate material editor. So wherever we require for the unwrapping, we can easily unwrap it. So let's start with the wall part over here. Let's go into the material over here. So let's go into this let's take a slate material editor. Let's go into V-Ray material editor and let's rename it as wall over here, and we can assign a color to the wall. So we'll be assigning a yellowish tint to the wall over here. If you want a bit of reflection on the wall, you can slide give a bit of reflection. After that, just select the floor section over here. Let's go again into the material, take a V-Ray material, go into diffuse, go into the bitmap, and I have taken a texture, that's a carpet texture over here. So after you assign this texture, it's not fitting well. We need to increase its tiling over here. Go over here, set it to UVW map. So now you can see that the texture is perfectly setting according to that stuff. So if you want, we can add some noise over here. We can add a bump mask over here. So you can just take a noise over here and let's connect it to the bump map. Into the bump map, you can just set it to fractal and reduce its value to 0.5. So that should be negligible. After that, set up a wooden texture over here. So select this. So always rename the textures, that would be easy for understanding. So we can rename this as a flow carpet over here. If you want to assign a normal map, you can go with the normal map also. So again, go over here and let's take a V-Ray material. Go into the diffuse, go into the bitmap, and we'll be taking a wooden texture. So I have already taken a wooden texture, high resolution texture over here. Rename it as wood over here. So right click, convert to editable poly, and give UVW map. Set it as a box. So after you have set this texture as a box over here, you can still adjust this properties to fit the texture in the correct way. So once you're done over here, it's not necessary you always take the same texture, you can also take a different texture as well. So go into reflective properties and assign a bit of reflection over here. So once you assign a reflection, that would look good over here. So same thing we are going to assign for the bed also. So let's assign the same texture for the bed. Let's convert to editable poly and let's give a UVW map. Set it as a box. So we can change the wooden texture, that's not a problem. So we can change, we can take some other wooden texture as well. So if we can get a high resolution texture for wood over here, we can definitely download that texture over here. So let's try this texture as well. So I'll just save this texture over here. So I'm taking a darker texture because the wall texture is much more lighter. So if you just go on with a lighter texture, it would be not that much appealing. I guess this is a much better texture compared to that. So we can adjust this wherever required. And also I have added some reflections over here for that. So let's add again, let's take a V-Ray material, rename this. Take again a V-Ray material for the mattress over here. Let's go into the bitmap and let's add. So I'll just first preview the texture. So whatever texture will suit the best, we can to that texture. So this is a perfect one. Assign this for the mattress over here. And let's again give a UVW map. After that, we can go into this and increase this. Tiling over here. So as you can see, the mattress part over here, and let's add the same bump map over here. So bump map definitely generates a bit of roughness over here. So if you want to give a bit of a rough look, we can just add a noise over here and let's connect it to the bump. So you can see this bump, you can set to fractal over here and set it to 0.2. So I need a very less roughness for it. Let's select this, take again a V-Ray material over here and let's assign texture for this kind of a wooden plank. That's it, looks much better. Just save your file. So after that, what I'll be doing over here is like, I'll be slightly, so select this, go into the material for the ceiling part, take a V-Ray material. So already we have assigned this texture, we'll be taking more darker texture if you want, or you can go with some other color, inverse that and the same color will be assigned. So we have taken this as a bit more darker compared to that. So let's again go into the material. Let's take a V-Ray material for the cushions and pillows. Assign that. And UVW map. Set it as a box over here. Adjust it accordingly, convert to editable poly. So assign in the same manner. So guys, if you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section over here. So we'll continue the rest of the part in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching this tutorial.